Father, you are here for you. Only for you. Thank all the glory. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. I don't know if you are ready for what is going to take place
today.
When I was coming into this country, by calling I'm a prophet, a teacher prophet, and my work is to go to nations and speak on behalf of the Lord. Not on my behalf. On behalf of the Lord. And the Lord told me, the first church I will send you to is a place I'm at ease. Understand what is happening is a spiritual
world.
It's a place I'm at ease. And the Lord told me it's a school. I never knew it was in a school.
It's
a school. And I said, okay. Father, I agree. I hope it belongs to you. When you send me, I go.
Amen.
The Lord told me, I choose those ones to carry something special. Now, please, don't clap yet. Because what I'm going to drop on you is a blessing.
It's
a covenant.
It's
a commission. But it can become a burden. It can become a burden. If you don't understand fully what the Lord wants to do in this continent. This church does not belong to you. It does not belong to Uganda.
Uganda,
it belongs to the whole Africa.
Ya Africa
for a special commission.
And
when I was coming here, and I entered the place, I was shocked. I said, Father, what is happening?
You
told me,
wangamba,
there are prophets there, there are teachers there, there are strong men in the spiritual realm. Where are they?
Baliwa.
And the Lord said,
come on, nangamba, to balaba.
There are things that human beings,
what we mean to abantu
with our sight,
namasogafe,
sure. But for God, He knows what He's doing.
Yes.
And just like the story of Gideon, the smallest one,
Omutono,
but he was the one the Lord chooses.
Ye katonda gwe yalonda
for the purpose of the whole country.
Olwabantu bonna.
Africa today,
Africa olwalero,
is sent by God.
Katonda ya jituma.
And I'm so happy.
Erandi musanyifu nyo.
Because we spoke about it.
Kubanga twachogerako.
When I saw her the first day,
bwe namola bonako lusoka,
and the Lord told me,
okama na ngamba,
that's my baby.
Oyo muwala wange.
Look at that. You know it. So your father calls you his baby.
Kachita umna.
You are his own baby.
Baby. Oli. Baby.
I said, okay. I greeted her, and that was all. I never knew I would come to address. Other bishops were saying, okay, on Sunday you will come to
address.
And 2 days ago, the Lord told me, that's where you are going to meet.
You are going to
meet. and listening.
Atuliza.
I started to call her.
Netani komu komu.
I said, give me this.
Nemugamba chino.
Give me that.
Ipane chino.
I wanted to make sure.
Nganja galoku biyoke.
All I asked of you.
Your navy kolo.
It was on purpose.
Your navy aliyachigeme dina.
If you said no,
singa wagan,
I could have understood.
Nali tegete.
That you were not the one.
It is siye kwe.
Asked you for food. Was on purpose.
Charlie Chachigende.
I asked you for internet.
Internet.
Was on purpose.
Charlie Chachigende.
Because what the Lord is dropping on you.
Mukama chapte kaku.
What is coming over your life? This nation is not enough to continue. I'm seeing the Lord opening doors for you to go and talk in
countries.
But listen, you need to duplicate yourself. You need to multiply yourself. But what to carry?
Just today.
Pour on them. Pour on this
people.
Release
to
these people. At times you must take services just to bless. At times you must take time only to bless your people. Because what you carry,
just today,
with time you will see. With time you will understand. My coming in this place this morning is just to remind to all of you. I never knew you. Now I can put a face to the people God loves. And because God loves you, there is a calling over Africa. The world is dying. Look at
Europe.
Confusion everywhere. All kind of nonsense. Look at
America.
Look at Asia. Even Africa.
Africa.
War everywhere. Commotion everywhere. Confusion everywhere. Because the Lord sent a special gift to Africa. None of us understood. And it was for the salvation of the world. We taught that ministry is coming to church, singing, dancing, screaming, receiving the word, and go back home. That is not ministry. Ministry is in receiving from God life, blessings, salvation, and share it in the whole world. When time came for America, and we were talking about it, they organized themselves for the rush out. And you can remember until they had great evangelists going into nations, preaching the gospel, bringing about salvation. You have heard that Bonke, Billy Graham, and all the names that you can know. They organized themselves and they did the work they had to do. The tears of the Lord. This time,
Kati,
is that Africa,
Africa
refuses to understand
egano kutegera
the commission
omulimu
on them.
Webalina.
Africa is loaded
ejude
with strange anointing.
I'm a footer again, Jauro.
Loaded men of God.
Gawa Senja Bakata Baman.
But they don't understand. That is not for their churches. It's for countries.
Oh, yeah.
It's for the whole world.
Yeah.
So the Lord sent me into this country to say, you guys, I have 20 years to come together. But 10 years have already passed.
That's what I was saying. That maybe
this will be a burden on somebody today. And the Lord is talking to Africa. Men of God, come together. People are dying. Go and preach the gospel.
But
Africans are looking for prosperity. Africans are looking for so things. Where are we heading to? So today, I get to remind you that is the time for Africa. This word has been released 10 years ago. And we are still fighting ourselves. We are still hating ourselves. People in church are so bitter. So much selfish. Because we don't understand that Africa today
Africa
is where God is.
Katonda wari. Katonda Africa lero.
So I'm in this country. It's my first time talking in this country. As a preacher. And I'm saying to you guys, if you don't understand, grace in a commission is not forever. Grace in a commission
is never forever.
For a commission,
grace have a time. You don't understand the time. You don't understand the season. God will take it and give it to somebody else. Because
people must be saved.
Yes.
John 7.
Because
everything I'm saying, if you understand these verses, you are the one I will be talking to. John 7:37-38. Are you there? Are you following me?
Yes.
Somebody is praying and crying in America.
God is seeing you. God is seeing
you. God is seeing you.
I say, my answer is already there.
The problem is that they are just
blind. They
are
distracted.
They are
following all kinds of things. They don't understand spiritual realm.
When you understand the calling of God, you enter into a realm. A realm where you are not the boss. He is the boss. And he will lead you the way he wants so that you can be useful into his hands. We want to master everything. We want to control everything. Just because we're not in another
way.
There is a level in Jesus. There is a place in Christ.
One way to form Christ.
In that place, your age, your background, your gender, everything you are, we just mix up with him.
With
his greatness. And from there, we will start to do things men never saw with their eyes.
Amen.
So this morning
is
an invitation to enter into that realm.
to enter into that dimension. I've learned with years and time never to look a person with my sight, especially a spiritual person. But what God is doing is not asking our permission. When God chooses you, He anoints you and He sends you, whether your pastor is aware or not. That's why men of God must be sensitive to the Spirit.
Ye nsonga lwaki abaweereza ba Katonda mulina okuwuliriza nnyo omwoyo.
Let's read verse 37.
Katusome olwa 7 omusanvu.
Verse 37 says, on the last and greatest day of the festival, Jesus stood and said in a loud voice, let anyone who is thirsty come to me and drink.
Verse 38.
Whoever believes in me, as the scripture has said, rivers of living water will flow from within them.
On the last and greatest day of the festival, there's always a day when the Lord will come to you to bring you into another level. There is always a day. There is always a season. There is always a time. Whether you are ready or not, the Lord, in His sovereign decision, will come to you and say, hey, let's go into another level. And that day is today. And that day is today. I said that day is today. That day is today.
The
way, the day you receive, the days you receive your calling was introducing the festival. The days you receive a burden was introducing the festival. The day you gave your life to Christ was the introduction of the festival. The day you receive in your heart the burden, I must do this to the church. I must do this in the ministry. I must do this to please God. I must do this as a child of God. Was introducing a festival. We are already in the festival day. Because the Lord wants all of us, not only to enter into eternity, but to be called at the end, good and faithful servant. And the Lord continued by saying, in a loud voice, let anyone who is thirsty,
who is thirsty,
are you thirsty?
Let
anyone who is thirsty with the intimacy with God, let him come and drink. Let anyone who is thirsty to see soul say, come and drink. Let anyone who is thirsty, are you thirsty to see a change in your family? Are you thirsty to see a change in your church, in your ministry, in your country? Are you thirsty to see a change in the world? The Lord said, come and drink. Problem is not the law. The problem is not the problem all over the world. The problem is Christians who are not thirsty to see a change. The problem is us. It's not homosexuality. It's not all kinds of nonsense around the world. The problem is you and I. We are not thirsty enough. We are not thirsty enough to receive this kind of power that will change things.
And
because you're not thirsty, cannot drink. When you are not thirsty, this water is there. If you are thirsty, it's an action you must make. You have to take the water. Not only take the water, you have to open the cover. Not only open the cover, you have to drink the water. If you are thirsty, you must look at problems. You must look at difficulties. You must look at challenges. Please open your eyes around you. Maybe you have food to eat. People, some of them, they don't have food to eat. Maybe you are in good health. Some are so sick. Some are dying. In their corpus, they are dying. Some are killing others because they think it's a way to handle their problems. Some are going into rituals. They are running to villages to seek for solutions because you never showed up as a solution. You don't even know that you are God's solution in this country. You don't even know that you are God's solution for the world. You are just there in your mind functioning with you and you and only you. You never ask God, where are you calling me to? Where are my limits? You are not thirsty, bro. Sister, you are not thirsty.
Sister, toli muyonta.
But Jesus says, and he's saying this morning, if you are thirsty, just discover
Zula
the kind. Just discover in your heart
Zula
the pain,
Obulumi,
the worry, the concern you have. And from there,
Okuvo,
something will start to shake in you. What is happening in Africa? We have everything it takes to be the most greatest countries in the world. But nothing can happen without God. Nothing that lasts can happen without God. And we don't understand it. We are not going into that realm, understanding. But we know there are problems out there. It's only by prayer that they will change. It's only with the presence of the Lord that they will change. I was in the capital city. My junior sister was sick. She was so sick that she couldn't walk anymore. And they actually sent me. All of us sent money. They went to hospital. Nothing changed. I was on mission in a village. They kept on calling me. The network was not going. As soon as I entered the city, I opened my phone. I received messages. With all the money we sent, nothing has changed. And she's so in pain. She's just crying. We gave her everything. All kind of painkillers. Nothing changes. And the Lord told me, the problem is you. You don't understand. That this situation is not money. It's your word. Speak to that situation. And when you will speak to the situation, something will change. And I started to look for money. I traveled to where she went. And the Lord said, I said, speak a word. I was forced to move. And I said, give her the phone. And I said, Father, you ask me to speak your word. I don't know the word that we speak, but I'm just saying, in the name of Jesus, be healed. For almost 7 days, she was lying flat. Nowhere to sit, nowhere to stand. I just said, in the name of Jesus, stand up and walk.
She stood up. Start to run around the garden. And people were screaming. Listen, myself, I was screaming more than them. I was shocked more than them. That
hey,
nothing happened. Because of what?
Or what?
I was not destined to see a solution. Are you destined? Brother, are you destined? There is something when you are thirsty that will push you in a realm where you are no more alone. You are walking with angels. When you give a word, they will run and do the work. When you say a word, you are not alone. You are in a realm listening. When you are a police officer, you are not alone. You have people around you. When you say a word, when you give an instruction, a policeman will run and fulfill the instruction. It's the same thing in the spiritual realm. You are a commissioner. You are a colonel. You have a rock that automatically send angels around you. When you release a word, they have the ability by God to travel, to bring solution there. But we are not
destined.
How come? In those days, the shadow of somebody can heal. How come? They were thirsty. Are you thirsty?
Oli muyonta.
Are you thirsty?
Oli muyonta.
This kind of anointing comes only when you are thirsty. When you are seeking for solutions. When you are going into this intimacy to ask, Father, how can I be a solution? Father, how can you use me to be a solution? Oh God, I'm available.
Wendy,
I'm available.
Wendy,
let anyone, no title here, no gender here, no age here. Let anyone, let anyone, let anyone who is thirsty, the only condition, are you thirsty? If you are thirsty, then go and drink by faith. Faith is knowledge. Our faith comes by knowledge. Faith comes by compassion. Faith comes by love. Mark my words, please. Faith comes by knowledge. Faith comes by compassion. Faith comes by love. When you love somebody, you want the person to be happy. And when there are crises, out of this love, we call on solutions. Are we still brethren in church? Are we still brethren in church? Are we still brethren? Before we were carrying our burdens. When the brother is sick, the church is sick. But nowadays, not here in Uganda, maybe only in Cameroon, people are selfish. People are so selfish. When the brother is not in church, there will be no call after the service to find out, brother, are you okay? Sister, are you okay? Is there anything right? Just church. You didn't came to church. I knew it was not the most converted. We are churching
brothers.
Nowadays, we're coming together and cry for the country. Father, salvation. I don't know about you here. But in our country, we are praying every day for youth.
Get
into alcohol.
abali mu mwenge. They are into all kind of nonsense. Bali mu bintu byonna ebikwasa ebyo. Because they are looking for pleasure. Kubanga banonya sanyu. They are looking for something only God can answer. Banonya ekintu nga Katonda ikayachi. But they don't know God. Naye ate nga tebamanyi Katonda akirina. How are we going to solve this matter? Tugenda kubataasa tutya mu buzibu buno? Only with people that are thirsty. Bantu bokka abayonta. Today, olwaleero, God is talking to all of us. Katonda ayogera naffe fenna. Are we thirsty? Tuli bayonta. Are you happy with what is happening in your country? Oli musanyufu na kyekigenda maaso mu ggwanga lyo? Are you happy with what is happening around the world? Bw'olaba ebigenda maaso mu nsi ng'osanyuka? If you are happy, it's okay for you. Bw'oba oli musanyufu munaye kiri bulungi. Tukwogera naawe naye nze. I'm not happy. Nze siri musanyufu. I'm not happy. And we're talking about organization. We need to learn how to organize ourselves. If you don't organize, we will never progress. If we don't organize, we will never progress. Our aim is not to stay here. It's to have our plot of land and build the ministry. Not only build a story building or whatever, but build warriors, lovers of God, friends of God.
Amen.
People that God knows, that can rely on in this country, in East Africa, in Africa,
Africa,
and all over the world. When God sent the commission to the continent, I was telling her, it's in three dimensions. Finances,
Simbi,
administration,
and
then the world.
Nechigambo.
Are you getting me? And you must go deeper and ask God, what is our role in this global thing? In all the countries I've been, in Africa, and talk about this thing, I discover
Zula,
that many countries,
they
think
Baroos,
that because God said, when you will do something in
Africa,
that is only on them. So you come to Cameroon, many of those men of God, we say, now is Cameroon style. It's wonderful. It's not only Cameroon.
See Cameroon yoka.
It's all Africa.
Africa yonna.
That must come together.
You know, kuatira wamu.
And organize themselves.
Betegeke.
To reach out the world.
Okufuruma okugenda
yes. So some we bring the finances.
Abamba jakuleta sente.
Infrastructure.
Bajja kuleta.
Some we bring.
Abamba jakuleta.
People.
Abantu.
That we stand
as
administrators to arrange the places we are going to preach, how we are going to put things together, authorizations and so on. The same people will arrange intercessors, will arrange the mass choir, will arrange ushers, because salvation is a project. And I'm talking about the word. But just bring it into this church.
It's
the same thing. For you to preach the gospel and win souls is a whole system you must put together.
System
those who look for the places to preach, those who will preach, those who gather resources and those who follow up. So one country cannot do that. It's not possible. It's not possible. And I'm seeing us. We are happy. It's our time. It's our season. How we are talking good. We are saying so great things. Unless we reach Europe, we have not done anything yet. unless we reach America and bring them back
to the gospel.
They have not done anything. Unless we reach Asia with the word of God, the kind of organization that no one can resist. You come to finances, they are ready. You come to the spiritual realm, they are ready. In all the domains, they are ready. Because they are one. That is the challenge of Africa. We don't know how to come together. We don't know how to put our strength together. We are so much divided. And the Lord is sending an advice in this country. And you must carry that word. You must carry that word.
Because
I'm talking to pastors. The Lord is sending a warning. If you're not coming together, I will make sure to remove some of you. Now, it's becoming a burden.
Ati chifu kwa mugugu.
How are you going to talk to great and big men?
Ugenda kogero tena basajia
wanene. That knows they are God's personal friends. No one can talk to them. Whoever believes in me, as scripture says, verse 38, rivers of living water will flow from within them. And I was saying, faith comes by what?
Knowledge.
Hearing. That hearing must bring knowledge.
Leto kumanya.
Okay. Knowledge.
Kumanya.
Love.
Kwagala.
Compassion.
No komu aku.
And Jesus says,
yes, wagam.
If you have those two things,
bobodi nevi.
It means you believe in me.
Chitegeza mozikiririza.
It means you believe in me.
Chitegeza mozikiririza.
Now,
kati,
because we believe,
kubango kiriza,
rivers of living water.
Emige jama zamaram.
Maybe my Bible is wrong.
No.
I'm seeing here rivers.
Ndabe emiga wano.
Amen.
Rivers.
Emiga.
Rivers.
Emiga.
Meaning,
ekitegeeza nti,
that in all the domains of affairs of men,
mu byonna byonna ebikwata ku bantu,
there is a river in us.
Waliwo omugga muffe.
In economic, there is a river in us.
Waliwo omugga.
Now, if you believe,
obokiza,
we can change so many things.
So choose bingi.
In family,
mu family,
there is a river.
Mulimu omugga.
There is a river on us.
Waliwo omugga muffe.
That can bring reconciliation.
Ogusobola okuleta okugga.
That can bring back peace.
Okusokomyawo
emirembe. That can bring back unity.
Busokuzza obumu.
Name the domain.
You get it, you know.
There is a river in you.
Waliwo omugga muto.
Name the domain.
Bako cho yogera.
There is a river in you.
Awaliwo omugga muto.
So today,
kati lero,
the church,
ekkanisa,
is God's hand on earth.
Mukono gwa Katonda ku nsi.
Where you see a problem,
wola bekizibu,
you are part of the solution.
Oli kitundu ku ky'okuddamu.
Where you see a problem,
wola bekizibu,
you are part of the solution.
We kitundu ku ky'okuddamu.
Don't stay aside.
Todda tobye samba.
Don't stay behind.
Tobye samba tobye jam.
When you pray,
bosaba,
enter into another realm.
Yengira mu nsendala.
Father, what is happening in Ukraine?
Tata chechi gena maso mu Ukraine.
Can I be a solution?
Nyinzo kuwe ky'okuddamu.
I'm not hearing any amen.
Amen.
Because for you, it's too far.
Is there any distance
with the Spirit?
Is
there a distance with the Spirit?
Why are you
afraid? There are some places, Runa Bonke came in Africa, he never even heard about the name.
He never heard about the name of the
village. People went ahead, organized everything. He came with the word. And the Lord, it's the same thing with us. Let's grow. Let's grow. Let's grow. Let's grow. Understanding. This man of God,
musajja wa Katonda
a bishop in Dawosa.
Bishop Dawosa.
Benson in Dawosa.
Bishop Dawson.
I don't know if you heard about him.
Simanyo wa mwari mwari deko.
That great man of God.
Musajja wa Katonda
in Nigeria.
In Nigeria.
In the 70s, 80s.
Mu nsambu chinane yo.
He was serving God so much.
Yali aweleza Katonda nyo.
And in those days.
Munakwezo.
Muslims were just killing Christians anyhow.
Sorry.
Muslims.
Abasilamu. Abasilamu bali bataba abakristayo ngabwe bagala.
Wishes and wizards were the star on TV.
Abalogo nabafumu ngaku
TV babera
ko bazefuga.
And then we say God does not exist.
Ngabage nane
bagamba. There is no God.
Teri katonda
tuliwo.
Fe tuliwo.
And the man said, Father,
omusajja nagamba
ta. What is this nonsense?
Nini bitali mu
bichi? What is happening? And the Lord said, because the church is quiet, the church is afraid. If one of you is courageous, you must confront and defeat those nonsense. And the next day, he heard about a man that is coming on the
TV
to challenge churches. And he stepped in the
studio.
I say, hey, before you were talking, now somebody will answer you. What are you saying? I'm saying that God does not exist. I'm powerful. And no one can stand against me. And he said, those are the last words you open your mouth and say. Fall and die. And the man fell and died. I don't understand.
Wow.
I don't understand. No one can challenge God where you are.
You keep
quiet.
Yes.
It's because you don't know who you are serving and even who you are. In the program on TV, everybody saw it. The man collapses in front of cameras. Was the end of it. He went to the site when they were killing Christians. And he entered the city. And said, as from today, the man of God is in the city. You kill one Christian, you will kill 100 Muslims.
He
said, what are you talking about? Let's try. And the Bible came alive. One Christian were killing 100 of Muslims. I'm not talking about films.
So
they were killing with cutlasses. It was a real fight. But one Christian
will
stand against 5, 10, 20, 100 of them.
We
defeat them. Because of what?
Right.
The man of God asked all of them
to
come in church with their cutlasses and say, I bless those weapons of God. Let them not be
alone.
Stand with them. And that thing stopped. Another day he asked to organize a program in a stadium in Lagos. They gave the okay, and something like 2 days before the day of the crusade, they called him and they say, oh, you know,
we
are changing everything.
We
are changing our mind.
We
must postpone the crusade.
He
asked for what for? And
they
say, because there is an international match that we
call.
And say, so is the only stadium in this Lagos people can come and play.
The
word of God first.
And
the government says, we are the one to decide. That your gospel will come after. And the man said, okay,
there will
be no match. Let's see what if you have a match in this stadium. The players came from another country. The players of
Nigeria came.
And while getting to the stadium, all of them, they felt sick. with the staff.
Everybody.
And there were no match. And they called him. They say, hey, man of God. We know it's you. Come and pray for them.
They
will die. And the man said, you must understand in this country, God first. He prayed for them. They were all here. I said, but you play the match after my
crusade.
And all of you must be in the crusade. That's what they call power. Real power. But today they have a university. A huge plot of land. How? God told him, in that place, that is the area I'm giving to you. And he went there with no money, only with his staff. And they started to look at the place. And
they
were saying, God showed me this place up to that place. Not it. People from the village came. What are you doing in our side? What are you doing here? Started to scream. But wanted to beat them up. And he said, hey, are you God? The chief said, no. He said, I'm asking again. Are you more than God? The chief said, no. He said, is God that sent me here?
So,
let me do what I have to do. And I will go back. One of his elder, he said, Papa, please, let's run. Many people will kill us. Look at the numbers they are. They will kill us. Let's run. Let's run for our lives. The man turned to the elder. He said, I will never walk in my life with faithless people. Now, don't do this
all.
He turned to the elder. You don't deserve life. And the man, in front of the village, in front of everybody, the chief said, Oga,
chief,
I beg is your land. Don't kill us. This is your land. Don't pay any
debt.
How can a man say a word? And somebody dies like this. They say, I will not take it for granted. They say, And you say, okay. I'm a man of God. Let me pray for you guys. Dangote is coming from that village.
Dangote avamuchare
cho. The richest man in Africa.
We are not
getting it. He prayed for that village. He prayed for the people of the village. And Dangote is coming from that village. Because the blessings of the Lord are still alive. Even when the man of God is no more. Listen, friends. We are talking about God. The one who is forever and ever. Because in Mukama.
Tumuita Mukama.
Is it Mukama?
Yes.
Yes, I got it right.
Mukama. Rachitus.
Mukama.
Wamwete mukubiengalo. Mukama.
When you hear about Mukama.
Go wunda Mukama.
I think it's Mu.
Ndoza Muka.
Muka.
Ma. Yafuga wakuru mugasuwa. Tinskomuza mazari.
No one is greater than him. No one is larger than him. No one can go up my God.
That is the only one.
Mukama.
Tuogera kumukama. Kuibatu sinzolimi kubengalo.
If you are thirsty,
wohoni muyonta.
Mukama is ready for you.
Mukama akulindi.
If you are willing. If you are really,
Bobango Yagarosas,
Mukama is ready for you.
Mukama waited.
In my young age of faith, in the beginning of my faith.
Muntandikwa yokkiriza kwange.
I was just praying to be God's friend. Just to be a worshiper. Just to love on him. And that was enough for me. I was happy in that.
So
the kind I can stay the whole day. Just praising, singing, dancing, loving on him. And after something like 3 years, the Lord came to me. I said, okay, you asked for this.
Wasabachi.
Now, I'm giving you this.
Katinkuwane chino.
I never asked for a prophetic ministry.
Ndesi sabanga kukubeira na bisibi sabanga koto ndami.
Never.
Sisi sabanga.
But the Lord decided
that
you will serve me into prophecy.
Nagamba ya kumpeleleza mbunabi.
And I said, Father.
Nemugamba ta.
Wait.
Linda.
I said, Father.
Nemugamba ta.
I don't want to be a chin-chin prophet.
You know
chin-chin? Chips. You don't know chips?
Crack. Chips.
Something like just eating, you know. I don't want to be any kind of prophet. You come into prophetic ministry.
You
want to talk over nations. And you say agree. So the man talking to you today is not in to please you.
He's
in to warn you. If you are thirsty, God will open your eyes. And you will see strange things. You will do things, you will be surprised. If you are not thirsty, you will remain the same. But God is still looking for a person to work with. May he find that person here. May he
find
the person in this church.
Amen.
The people that will love him so much. The people that will be in intimacy so much that if he wants to destroy Uganda because of you, if he wants to destroy your family because of you, say, Lord, because of me. Lord, because of me. Because of me, bless my
home.
Because of me, bless my family.
Lord,
because of me, find a solution to the Western world. Because of me, let the gospel be preached all over the world. Because of our friendship, oh God, open my eyes. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
So I didn't came to preach.